Hey guys, how's it going? If you look in my hand, I have a Volt Rock, and that can only mean one thing. We're gonna start this episode off with a recipe. Let's ignore these crates. We'll get into this just a little bit, but this is actually not too bad. I think I have pretty much everything I need. I lied. I do not have everything I need. I'm actually short on, I think, almost everything. Well, I'm short on this thing and that thing. So let's throw what we do have on here, and then we'll go ahead and get some netherrack. Oh, we have all the netherrack. I guess we just need to get some apples. Thankfully, I've been having these oak trees growing for quite a while now, so this is the perfect time to go ahead and cut them all down and then let the leaves despawn while the apples hopefully spawn. I think I only need like seven, so it shouldn't be a problem. I ought to get all of those from these oak trees over here because there is a ton of leaves. While we're at it, I'm going to go ahead and cut down the birch trees as well just so I can replant them because you never know what's going to show up in the altar. And you know what? We've got time. Let's go ahead and harvest up all of this sugar cane as well. Then we just got to sleep through the night, put all of this stuff in our storage system, and then hopefully with just a little bit of time, all those apples should hopefully fall from the tree. I guess while I wait for that, I'm gonna go ahead and roll the footage from all of these crates right here. And you can see I ran a couple volts off camera. Nothing really too crazy. I didn't really talk too much throughout them. I was basically just trying to have a relaxed episode. And a couple of the volts, we got some pretty insane luck. I'm just gonna roll the footage right now. Oh, no way. This is a pretty good starter room. You've got to be kidding me. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed those volt runs that we did. I know I didn't talk too much, but like I said, I was just kind of trying to relax a little bit. And knowing my luck, no apples spawned. Had a single apple, so I came over here and got a villager, and he happens to trade apples. So let's go ahead and get these apples and put them right here. And before we run this vault, I want to open up all of these crates just in case we get some loot that we can go ahead and roll up because I am level 26 now. Before we do that, let me clear out the inventory super quickly, and then I'm going to be right back and we're going to open up all of those crates. I hope you guys are as excited as I am. I went ahead and cleared out my inventory so we have plenty of space. Let's make sure that this magnet is turned off. And here we... Oh my gosh. Okay, there's so much loot that it's actually making me lag. Let me go ahead and pick some of this up. And let's turn the magnet back on so we can start sorting it into these chests over here. I'm just going to go ahead and just shift click everything and then that will fit. We got 30 gold from all of that and 2 platinum. Oh my gosh, that is insane. And now it's time to check out all the loot that we got. 61 volt diamonds, a ton of gold right there, and then some platinum. I know we got that a minute ago. And I know I got some actual gold. Yeah, 8 of them, I guess, from whenever I was running all of the volts. Tons of knowledge essence. Look at all these ores. Over a stack of Lirimor. Then we got a couple of these filler things. We did get a mod box that I want to go ahead and open up. And, oh, 2 knowledge shards. Nice. And that one wasn't too crazy. But now, for the moment we've been waiting for, look at all of this gear. Over an inventory full. You can see some's like level 22, but then we have some that are level 24 and all that. So I'm going to grab all of the common gear. We're going to roll this up, and then we're going to come back for the big mama jamas, like the commons and then the rares. We probably won't get anything too crazy, so let's go ahead and... Boom. Oh, a goat chest plate. Wait, where is it at? I want to see what that looks like. Whoa, wait a minute. Why is this one? Look, it's like rainbowish. That's kind of cool. Is this like a special transmog or something like that? Oh, that looks sick. That looks amazing. And we got 20% trap disarm. That is insane. What I'm going to go ahead and do is put all of the gear in here, and then we'll check it out after I finish rolling up the good gear. Let's see what we get. We're going to come over here, and then once again, we're going to go ahead and bam, witch leggings. So we got another epic item. I cannot wait to see what those look like. Okay, nice. But check it out. This one isn't rainbow. So I wonder what's so special about that goat chest plate that we got. Oh my gosh, look at this sword. Wow. Okay, we're gonna have to put a little another empty prefix on here because that is insane. All right, so yeah, you can see right there, once again, that one's a little bit rainbow, so please let me know down in the comments what that means. But these are all the different chest plates that we got. Then we're gonna move over to the leggings. These witch ones are pretty insane. Look at that item quantity and rarity. Then we got a couple of decent swords. I think this is gonna be our best bet. We're gonna get a healing cloud plus a ton of attack damage. And then check out this helmet. This one's not that bad either. We still have an empty suffix, so I'm gonna roll that up. What I'm gonna do is grab all the items that I think have potential. We're gonna roll that up and then get a whole new set of armor. So after looking through that, I think the only thing that I really want to replace is gonna be my chest plate and then also these leggings. And then let's check out the damage increase we get on the sword. Currently we're doing 54.7. That is a ton. But if we equip this new one, 69.7 damage. That is insane. 15 more damage that we're doing. That is awesome. But what we can do now is go ahead and start trying to get some more prefixes on here. I think I want to use these. Yeah, so 4 health is pretty good. And then increased damage. That's also awesome. And then over here, we can put plus 3 armor. That is huge. And then with the sword, we're going to get 10% soul chance. That's not too bad. I don't really want to roll that one up too much because I love that attack damage and healing cloud. We are going to be unlocking a new mod today. And also check out my new armor set. I think it looks pretty nifty. Before we unlock that new mod, I want to go ahead and run that vault from that crystal we just crafted. That way I can kind of think about what mod I potentially want to get. Also, you guys let me know that that ability power from that wand gives us increased damage to things like this, the fireball. So I'm going to go ahead and select this, and we're going to try it out in this new vault. We can get spawly or fire shot. I think I'm going to just keep the normal fireball for now, and we'll kind of see where that takes us. All right, guys, so I got a wand. Let's open up this portal and figure out how this fireball works. Looks like we got a pretty simple scavenger vault, and looks like we got looter's dream and then also our favor. So we got to do a Windara one. If we complete this, we'll get an extra point to our favor system. And this room isn't loading, but based on the textures, is a little bit different. It looks like a village room with some living chest, I believe. But since it's not on our bounty thing, we're not going to really worry about that just yet. Okay, here's some zombies right here. Let's actually go ahead and test this out. Nothing happens when I right or left click, so maybe it just... let's see. Oh, okay, that was actually kind of sick. There's a huge cooldown on there, and I'm kind of making a mistake by going to all these different POIs. It's not the strongest thing, so let me take these guys out, and then I see a couple of ornate boys. Let's actually loot these up, and maybe... Okay, we got one empty jar from there. We got both empty jars already, so that's those checked off. Now we just need some coin files and some gilded chest, and to get rid of these zombies. Hey, speaking of Windara, we got another altar right here, and that one actually gave us an idol, which is pretty sick. Oh, and some gilded boys up. Oh, that's a tier 2 skeleton with a bow. That's going to be pretty dangerous, so let's get them out the way. That's not too bad of a deal now. And we got some gilded boys, so hopefully we get those red scrolls that we're needing. It looks like we got one right there, and 2 of them, so that's pretty good. We're off to a good start. Oh, and here's a turning station. Let's go ahead and put those empty jars in here. And I also heard that if I shift right click with that, yes. So it looks like it will start... Nope, I need that back. But I'll start pointing to the actual objective, which is insane, because now I don't gotta worry about getting lost and trying to find one last minute. And you know what? I did say I want to unlock a new mod. I might actually get 2 mods this episode. It really just depends how much knowledge I have. So I'm gonna really have to start going towards those little living chests. You know what? This seems like the perfect chance to try out our new fireball. Let's select the wand and... Okay, yeah, I probably gotta upgrade that because the damage is just not there currently. Oh, we came across an ornate dungeon, so let's get into a little bit of a looting montage. A small montage, but a montage nonetheless. Oh, guys, check it out. Another one of these little types of doors. I was coming over here and I saw some gilded chests. Let's get these, and then we're going to go ahead and go through that door, and maybe we'll get lucky. It might even be a gilded dungeon, which is honestly what we're needing. Oh, no, we actually need a coin one currently. So let's open up this door. Okay, normal difficulty. That's not too awful bad. It looks like it's going to be... Oh, okay, wait a minute. Can they go through here? Oh, they can't. I actually might have... Yeah, that might have been a mistake. Can I knock them back? I can. But okay, let's just make a run for it and build up. And it looks like it's a living one. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Yeah, okay, this is not going good. I do not want to die. We may just have to, we may just have to go the other way. You know what? No, let's try this again. Let's try this again. Just build up as fast as we can. Okay, nice. We're in a good spot. Let's get rid of these elites. And like I said, I know this is kind of cheesy, but can you guys blame me? Y'all really can't currently. I hear more, so that kind of worries me. Oh, they're probably downstairs. No, okay, I'm just gonna loot these ones and then we'll try to go downstairs because I do need a ton of knowledge essence. Okay, some of them made their way towards me. Oh, healing cloud, I need that. Go ahead and heal me up just a little bit. Okay, yeah, yeah, okay. This is a little bit more manageable, just a couple here and there. Is that gold blocks in there? Oh my gosh. Oh no, okay, it's just gravel. Oh, whoa, wait a minute. That's like a boss one. This guy's gonna probably do a ton of damage. Oh my gosh, yeah, he does a ton of damage and he's super quick. He is incredibly fast, but we got this, I think. I hope. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Oh, that was tough. I think that was all of them though, so now we can go ahead and continue looting up the chest. This dungeon is absolutely massive. This is a lot bigger than that last one. And I think that last one I got was hard difficulty. But in my opinion, this one seems harder than that one. But there are so many living chests in here. This is going to help us out a ton with our quest for the knowledge. Oh, and check it out. There's actually sacks in here. So if you find one of these super early on, that could be super useful. Actually, no, not really, because I think pouches are automatically unlocked. So yeah, ignore what I just said. I'm going to go ahead and turn these red scrolls. So now all we have is a correct script. Let me get rid of these bad boys as well. Oh my gosh, check it out, guys. We should, without a doubt, be able to get all the correct scripts that we need from here. Let me get some blocks on my inventory. And hopefully we get it from these ones up here. Oh, there's a boss one up there as well. Oh my gosh. Yeah, if we're lucky, we're going to go ahead and get it from these ones. Because going down there is going to be pretty dangerous, as a lot of mobs have a chance of spawning. We did not get it from here, so we're going to have to make our way down and just be super careful. I'm going to try to do that trick that I did the last time where I built a little hole. That way nothing can really get us, but at first I want to take this bad boy out. One more hit. Oh my gosh, he dropped a pog? That is insane. Okay, you know what? No, I don't want to cheese it. I'm just going to go and break his... Oh my gosh, another one of these guys. Please drop another pog. That would be super insane. It didn't. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Just give me the item I need, please, so I can get out of here. Okay, I think I got the item, but there is another boss right there that I want to take out, because now that I know they can drop pogs, this is makes it completely... Oh, I'm getting greedy. I'm getting greedy. Yeah, yeah, I'm gonna get out of here. These guys are extremely tough. I really wish I could have gotten a... You know what? We're gonna risk it for the biscuit. Oh my gosh, and then a creeper spawns, of course. Oh, I almost missed an item right there. Another idol. As long as I'm fast enough and don't stop moving, I should be good. As long as these guys don't kill me. There's a creeper. Okay, so it's kind of working out. I'm healing up as I go, and I'm also just kind of blocking things off as well. That way no mob can continue getting us. I see that I've gotten a ton of cracked scripts, which is good. I'm not going to get too more greedy. I just want to get all these easy coin piles, like over here. And then we're going to get out of here. And this is perfect because I want to make that soul diffuser. That way we can start turning all these extra items into soul shards. Okay, I think I got greedy enough. There's still a ton of coin piles in the middle, but we'll leave those for these guys. Guys, we found another challenging. Okay, that's not good. This is... Oh my gosh. Don't know really what to do with these. I don't know. Hopefully, I mean, personally, I think this is going to be a little bit easier because they're zombies and they don't hit nearly as hard. Plus, there's a lot of rails here, so I don't think they want to cross them. No. Oh my gosh, an epic plus magnet. Kind of feel bad cheesing those guys, but I mean, you can't really blame me, can you? I mean, it's there. I'm going to consider it a game. But where did I get these relic fragments from? Okay. And I got a key piece. An unidentified treasure key. They had to have came from those boss mobs. So note to self, kill every boss mob that we see because they have a chance at dropping some insane gear. Yeah, I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be honest. I think that this challenging one is easier than that normal one that I came across a minute ago. Oh, another one of these guys. So let's take him out and maybe we'll get another key piece or possibly a pod. And what are we gonna get? There's no telling. Okay, it looks like a helmet. Oh, I was not paying attention to the time. Let me get greedy. Let me get greedy. Yeah, we got 3 minutes left, and I think I'm a pretty good ways away from the actual little turning station. Or there can be one in the center of this room that I completely missed coming in here. Nice. Oh my gosh, I need a cracked pearl. Wrong item, wrong item. Okay, I got scared. I thought it was a cracked script. That could have been bad. Let's head back to the base and see what kind of loot we got. 20,000 experience, 351 coin piles collected, and look at all of the chests. That's a ton of living chests, and that's a ton of ornate chests. Flame this up. Without a doubt, this has probably been the... What is that? Oh, okay, that's grass. It looks like a mob. All in all, I think this is probably the most insane vault that I've ever done because just for the sole purpose of this, we got a treasure key from that. So that's going to save us some echo, which is surprisingly super duper cool. And I'm going to be honest, I'm not going to take that wand with me anymore. To me, it didn't really feel like it did anything. I probably was using it wrong, to be honest. Let's go ahead and place this down before we check out the pouches. Let's turn the magnet off and open this up. Wow. Look at all of this gear that we're getting. It's 3 more platinum to add to the collection. That is insane. And look at that mining speed, +6 mining speed. And it's only 12 size. That's insane. Now I want to go ahead and roll up all of this gear. I don't have the key with me. We're going to save that for later. Look at all the new unlocks. It looks like we got an Ender Wand. So, oh, that looks sick. 18 ability power. Okay, you know what? That looks amazing. Okay, I'm going through everything and look at this. +1 level to Javelin Sight. So that's gotta be something new. That is honestly super insane that you can get additional lever. Oh my gosh, look at this magnet. Yeah, I mean, this is the one I currently have. It is Omega, but this one gives me better item quantity and rarity. So we're gonna switch to that. Now, what I wanna do is roll up this treasure key. It's a Xenium one. Okay, that's not too bad. I mean, come on, guys. Y'all know what this means. We have to run another vault. We gotta try and find this treasure room. And this is my first pog. Technically, I didn't craft it, but we are gonna go ahead and still frame it up here. It's honestly even better that I didn't have to craft it. We got this one basically free. And then look at all this copper. Oh, I almost forgot about the relics. Let's roll this. Knowledge shards. And okay, this is a super rare one that I think. And then we have these. I know I don't have enough to create a set yet, but that is going to help out later on down the line. It must not be too rare because I have two of them. So from that one dragon room, we got 23 gold. I have all of my copper and stuff. I went in and took the ones down that we had up there. We're going to transmute this all over here into some platinum to see exactly how much we have. Okay, moment of truth, 21 platinum. That is absolutely amazing. We're going to put that there. We're going to put the gold here, silver, and then we'll put the copper right here. That is a hefty pile. It looks like we forgot to roll up some leggings, so let's go ahead and roll those bad boys up. Imagine we get no mega from here. We didn't, but it is a new one. It's a Shadow King Transmog. My current ones are a lot better personally. But check it out, guys. Look at the knowledge that we have. I know we have more in here. I want to get ready to start crafting up all the knowledge shards that we're going to need. That's why I went ahead and brought all this Larimar up. We're probably about to break that stuff up. So in total, we can make 13 knowledge shards. Plus, I have that one over there. So that's going to bring us up to 14. And what I'm wanting to do is unlock the refined storage mod because I'm sick of not having a crafting table. And we're probably going to go with Palace. So we have plenty of knowledge shards. I already have some Larimar, so we might not even have to actually break any of the ores that we have down. I'm just going to go ahead and craft all of these over here into their perspective little perfect ones, and then over to the extraordinary ones. I don't need Larimar. I need Biniatite. Please tell. Okay, I can't turn those back. I was about to be super bummed out. Thankfully, it looks like we have a good bit of Biniatite. We may still have to go ahead and break down the ones that we do have, though. Oh, actually, we are not going to have to because we got 12 extraordinary biniatite from that. Now I got my vault diamonds. We're going to come over here, put these around like this. One more set. That's going to bring us 9 knowledge cores. Now we can come back over here, get our knowledge shards, and then surround these things with those. And we're going to get 9 knowledge stars. Oh, you know what? I didn't even need to do that because I had one right here. But let's go ahead and eat these up. Yum. Now we can come over here and unlock that refined storage mod and also the power mod. Nice. Oh, and I completely forgot we got new transmogs. That reminds me, we can probably go ahead and come over here. Is there a which one is the transmogrification table? I'm gonna go ahead and make it. I'm not gonna really worry about trying to complete these bounties. We should have everything that we need. We sure do. So let's bring this in. We're gonna set this right here for now. And okay, I need it looks like copper. I put it all over here. So now I gotta break this and I'm gonna completely switch all of this platinum down to 1 copper, or I say 1 copper, mini copper. wrappers just so we can keep it in there in case we want to transmit stuff later on. Oh, this looks pretty cool. Let's put this right here. I don't want to look at it just yet. I want to get the entire set just so we can kind of have like a little surprise going on. All right, I got the entire set. Let's try it. Oh my gosh, that is huge. Oh my gosh. I don't remember if I had this set last season, but it looks absolutely wonkers. How does it look when I walk? This is just huge. Oh my gosh, this is insane. Look at how big my fist is without it. It's that small, and look at it, how big it is with it. It takes up half of the screen. So if you guys look at my inventory, it looks a bit wonky, but we're going to craft up our first POG because I need to start crafting up everything we need to get all these different things going. So we're going to start off with the storage system. We're going to craft up that POG like this, and we should basically have just about everything that we need. There's the grid right there. We're going to get this disk drive. This is going to require 2 black chromatic steel ingots, which is kind of a bummer, but we do have a ton of black opal. Let me just grab it from the system. And we even have some that we actually haven't even mined up. We have those and then a couple in that chest right there. But for now, we're just going to use these 2 ingots like this. Do that, craft up the 2 black chromatic steel ingots like that. Then we got to make a machine casing, which is kind of expensive. I think we need 2 of these, if I'm not mistaken. We'll craft up this bad boy. Then we need the controller, which is another little bit of things like this. And then a little bit of wire. And I just need some glass and redstone. And that should basically be everything we need to get a very, very basic system set up like that. Let me make sure I got my glass. And then obviously we're going to need a power source, which is why I unlocked the power mod. But for now, let me show you guys how this stuff works. So similar to simple storage, this is basically going to be like the heart of the system. And instead of using chests, we could still use those chests if we wanted to, but we're going to have everything digital. It's going to all be used in this little block right here. We'll put the grid up there, which will be transferred over to the crafting grid soon. And then this wire, I believe we need it if we're going to set up chests and stuff like that, but it connects just like that. Now let me just get a power source, and I'm going to show you a super simple one using the power mod. The power system we're going to make is going to be the thermal generator. You're going to start off with needing some of this dielectric paste. It's super cheap, so I already made a stack of it. Then you're going to need a dielectric casing, but first we're going to need these rods and these horizontal rods, which are honestly pretty cheap. I'll make about 6 or so of each for now. And then once you have that, you need to make this casing just like this. We just need the one for now, and we're going to need a couple capacitors. I need a little bit more Larimar though. So in total, I need 5. So I'm just going to make the 6 for right now. And now all we're missing is these thermoplates, which cost a couple of blaze lanterns. And these things are kind of pricey, but I should just need the 12 like that. And then I should be able to make up 3 of these bad boys. And now the thermo generator. These can be upgraded. This one currently is going to make 20 FE per tick, which I think should be plenty for what I'm needing it for. And if it's not, I could always make this upgraded version like this without having to actually make any of the new machines that you need to get like the energized steel. The upgraded one still uses just basic materials. It's just going to be a bigger capacitor. And for demonstration purposes, we're going to go ahead and just set this up right here. We're going to put some lava below it. You could also use a magma block and then a blazing block of something. And each one's a little bit more efficient. Then what we're going to do is right click this with water, and it will start producing some power for us very slowly. It's only 20 FE a tick, but it should be everything we need to get the system running. We're also going to go ahead and place this right here so it can start receiving the power, and then we're going to put the grid just like this, and then the disk drive. And if we right click on here, we can see we're using 2 FE per tick that this is running. Once I start adding some drives and stuff like that and more advanced parts, it will go up with the energy usage. There is a way to automatically pump water into there. I just don't feel like making a sink because it's going to cost 2 more black chromatic ingots. So I'm going to go make an infinite water source and just fill it up as needed for now. And like I said, this is not going to be a permanent spot for this. It's just going to be here for now up until I get rid of this storage system. If you look over here, you can see there's a 1k, a 4k, a 16k, and I think it goes up to 64k. And each one of these that you make, you use 3 of these 1ks, and you basically get 1,000 extra storage items if you make the 4k. And then with this one, you'll get 4,000 extra storage items if you make the 16k, because it's only going to use 12k of these storage parts. For today's episode, I'm probably just going to go ahead and make one of those 4k ones, and the next episode will work towards this the 16k one, only because it does take a lot of this chromatic steel, and I'm running quite low on it. The main thing that I'm actually lacking is the chromatic steel. I have plenty of carbon and whatnot. So maybe next episode, if we end up finding one of those rooms that have a ton of that chromatic iron, we'll go ahead and try to mine all of that up. But once you have the item that you want, you're going to make one of these storage housings just like this. Oh no, we want to switch that over to the storage housing like this. We'll make that, and then you combine these two, and that'll get you a 4HK storage disk. And say you want to upgrade this later on, as long as it's empty, you can shift right click it, and you'll get that one right back. But let's put this in here for now, and you can see now we're going to be using 3 FE per tick, but we can start storing all the items that we want in here. This mod is also compatible with drawers and stuff like that, so we may start working towards unlocking that mod next episode. Can you leave? I think this is a pretty good stopping point though for this episode, so we're gonna go and end the episode here. Let me take this off. I really appreciate you guys for watching. Thank you guys so much. God bless you guys. Bye bye. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.